Hello, I'm Katie. I'm the educator here at Medela and I'm also a midwife and lactation consultant. I'd like to introduce you today to our lovely Medela mum, which is Lisa, and also the gorgeous baby Sophie.
All right, one of the other big questions that I suppose has come up for me is about when I know when she's starting to comfort suck. So I'm in the middle of the night where she's been on the breast a lot. I've started to think, is this just for comfort and to be close? Do we need to give a dummy?
Yeah.
Should I start to replace me with the dummy? How do I know when she actually needs it and when?
It's a really good question, but a tricky question. So in the first 4 weeks, because all the patterns are being laid down in your breasts, so in order to make all the milk you are ever going to need, in terms of how much you make per day, your body lays down those foundations in this first 4 weeks. And so what we know from babies is normally if they're awake and asking for food in that first 4 weeks, they're hungry and we need to satisfy their hunger. So the best thing is to not give them a dummy and just feed them on demand as much as they need. Even though for most babies this is very frequently, and up around the 12 times in 24 hours. Saying that, if you've given a dummy, or there's a time when you just go, I just can't do this anymore, I need a half an hour, I need a 50 minute break, I need a 2 hour break, that does happen, and it's normal, and it's okay. And if you give a dummy, I don't want you to feel terribly bad. The thing is though, if we use a dummy regularly, and we think, oh, baby shouldn't be feeding until 3 hours or 4 hours, and that's when we're using a dummy to push them out, we're actually gonna interfere with our milk supply. If you're having one of those nights where you just, it's gone on and on and on, and you think, I actually need a break, and it's also for a safety mechanism as well, I need a break, then that's okay. But the ideal is in that first 4 weeks, keep baby close, skin-to-skin contact when you can, feed them as much as they need to just really lay those patterns down so that we don't interfere with how much milk your breast needs to make and the signals going to your brain saying make milk.
Thanks for watching, and for more videos of me, Lisa, and baby Sophie, head to our breastfeeding blog.